Hello everyone, Adam here. Today I will show you some new revision of the 433 MHz frequency jammer, which can be used to jam car keys or the garage keys or stuff like these. Remember that you shouldn't build anything like this on your own because it may be illegal in your country. However, what I'm showing here is only to give you some clue how to construct some basic device for radio jamming. So I will still be using the FS1000A, the module which looks exactly like this. So it should have two coils. However, one isn't mounted here, but in reality it is, because it is basically this one, the SMD version of it. And if you want to know how the design looks of this FS1000A, here you have it printed with the difference that right here I'm putting some new element, which is a regulated capacitor. So this one is having from 5 picofarads up to 30 picofarads, and I will be using this to slightly modify the frequency of this saw oscillator, which you can see here. So it is connected to the oscillator. It will be connected to the oscillator between this pin and this pin. So I have already modified version of it. So remember to attach antenna. The antenna length should be adjusted to the frequency of the saw oscillator. So if you're having 433, then you should be using something like 16.5 centimeters. And as you can see, I have this regulated capacitor mounted directly to the pins of the saw oscillator, which will give me possibility to play with the frequency of this little device. So we will see that in a couple of minutes how I'm doing it. And regarding the new design of the jammer, so if you probably have seen my previous video, so I was using only single unit of FS1000A. Now I'm having three of it. They are connected the same way as the first one on the previous video, and the difference is that I had to add the capacitor between the VCC, so the voltage, and the ground line, just to block the interferences, because the chip and the internal clock of the chip was freaking out. So I had to add this one to keep it stable. And new design and new device looks like this. So I have to attach. So it is still the same chip, ATTINY 13, right here. Here is the capacitor that I added recently. Here we have two units of FS1000A with the regulated capacitors add ones, and I'm adding the third one right here. So three FS1000As, three antennas, and the power is still the same. These are three AA batteries, so it doesn't change. And in a minute I will show you how it works. I will be using RTL SDR dongle and the PC with the Ubuntu Linux to show you how it generates the noise on the frequency 433. So remember, if you're in the US or some other country that uses different frequency, probably you may want to look for the version of FS1000 8 with the different frequency, like 315 for US. So it is also sold by Chinese vendors. You have to look for it. Here in Europe I have 433. So in US there will be 315. Okay guys, so we'll meet in a minute. Okay, now I'm in the front of my computer and now we're gonna see how the FS1000A really generates the radio noise. And I will be using such device connected to my PC. So this is a RTL SDR dongle with some kind of telescopic antenna, which is which length is tuned to the frequency that is in the center of the GQRX on the screen. So let's begin. So I have this board with ATTINY 13, and I will now first connect the FS1000A, which are not modified, so they are not having this capacitor attached. So let's start with this one. Let's see what is the shape of the noise that it generates. So now I have to switch on the... Okay, now you can see the middle of the 433 frequency. Now I'll switch this one on. Okay, so as you can see, it generates two peaks. One is around 434. This is exactly 434, but we would like to have all bands covered. So what can we do? We can of course attach other units to this one. So if we attach a second unit, as you can see, this one changed a bit, so now the frequency is a bit wider and it may cover more of devices that are operating on this frequency, but it is not the end. So let's switch this one on. Off, sorry. If you have the unit modified with the capacitor, you can observe what is changed on the behavior. Okay, so as you can see, it generates some kind of noise, but it is not the one we would like to get. Let's use the capacitor in a minute to modify the behavior a bit. Okay, this one is not generating at all. Strange. Oh yeah, now it generates. So as you can see, we can tune a bit this behavior of this device. By using a screwdriver. Let's assume that we want to get a wider band. Oh yeah, now it is generating some noise. Okay, so you have to play with this to make this kind of distortion by using a screwdriver. And oh yeah, now it is quite fine. So you have to play with it and with all of three units that I had attached the capacitors, I have to do the same. Oh yeah, see here what it does. Makes a lot of noise. Yeah, let's check another one. It also probably needs to be fine-tuned a bit. Yeah, better, but not the best. Yeah, now it makes a lot of noise. too much probably. No, not the one. I believe I have to move up. Okay, let's leave it like here, okay? Let's leave it like it is. Okay, now if we attach all three of them to the board, it should add up. I mean, all these noises should add, and summary, it should generate a bit of traffic, a bit of noise. Okay, so as you can see, if I have this one switched off, I can see some noises, some, yeah, probably this is some kind of weather station sending some data here. But if I switch this one on, it will generate at least 20 dBm of noise. So this is what you want to achieve by using this kind of jammer. So right now I'm effectively jamming almost all of the frequency between 432 and 434, even more than this. If I switch that one off, you will still get these devices sending something, okay? Now switch this back on, and the noise is being generated. So you have to play with this a bit. You have to play with the screwdriver, tune up a bit, and then you may get a pretty good working jammer. Okay guys, that's all for now. If you enjoyed the video, please leave thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.